Russia. All risk, but plenty of reward. That's been the view from Saxo Bank's head of equity strategy, Peter Garnery, and chief economist Steen Jakobsen says he agrees with Peter.
I'm certainly coming into the camp of Peter. If you look at CAPE, cyclical adjusted price earnings, which is probably the most fair way to look at the market, you can either today buy the US at 24.25 or Russia at 6.7. Clearly, Peter has an argument, which is that if you are willing to take the volatility, if you're really ready to take the political risk, certainly the upside is in terms of buying Russia here.
But buying Russia at a time of crisis, sanctions and uncertainty, it's a bit of a gamble. It's Russian roulette.
The economy was in a free fall already before the incident. It will not be better off when they have to allocate this amount of resources to keeping troops on the alert 24/7. It's expensive and it's non-productive in terms of creating the mandate for change which is needed in Russia.
But why is Russia seen as an opportunity?
If things become too cheap, they need to reverse back to the mean. And I think that is really what you want to play on in Russia. It's not the fact that you believe that you know how the solution will ultimately be made in terms of Russia and the rest of the world. I still think there is more nervousness to come. What we are pointing out, what Peter's pointing out, if something trades at 6 and the US trades at 24, 25, the trade you want to do is not outright Russia, but you want to be short the US DAX against the Russian market purely on valuation and positioning.